Hello students, today we are going to know more about second category of matter, that is impure substances. These are also known as mixtures. Now the question arises, how can we form mixture, children, when two or more pure substances are mixed with each other but not in a fixed proportion? It is called as mixture. For example, I have one glass of water and I add 1 tablespoon of sugar in it. What is the name of this one? This is sugar solution. Second thing, if I add more amount of sugar in the same amount of water, then again it is known as sugar solution. Kya agar sugar ka amount badhane par us solution ki properties change hoti hai? Obviously aapka answer hoga nahi. Kam amount ke sugar mein bhi वो शुगर सॉल्यूशन कहलाता है, और अगर हम अमाउंट शुगर का बढ़ाते जाएं उस पानी के अंदर, अगेन इट इज कॉल्ड एज शुगर सॉल्यूशन. इट मींस इन अ मिक्सचर रेशियो ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स डज नॉट रिमेन कांस्टेंट. वी कैन इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज रेशियो ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स, बट स्टिल इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ सेम मिक्सचर. मींस शुगर सॉल्यूशन रिमेंस सेम, वेदर इट हैज मोर अमाउंट ऑफ शुगर इन इट or it has less amount of sugar in it. So the proper definition of mixture is, mixtures are formed by mixing of two or more pure substances, whether it is elements or it may be compound, but the ratio of these substances are not fixed. Mixtures are divided into two categories. First is homogeneous mixture and second one is heterogeneous mixture. Let us define homogeneous. Homo means uniform. As its name indicates, homo means uniform, and mixture means when components are mixed in each other but not in a fixed ratio. So homogeneous mixtures are also known as solutions. Homogeneous mixture ko hum solution bhi kehte hain. Heterogeneous. Hetero means non-uniform composition, means they do not have uniform composition. We will discuss these one with the help of some examples. They have non-uniform compositions which are further divided into two categories, colloids and suspension. So let us try to understand this one with the help of one example. I have here one glass of plain water. Yahan mere paas ek plain glass pani hai, okay. Now in second glass I have some amount of soil in it, dissolved in it. Okay. Now, if I continuous stirring it, it would be dissolved. इसको continuous stir किया, ये dissolve हो गया. Now, if I left this for some time undisturbed, अगर मैंने इस mixture को कुछ time के लिए बिना disturb किए छोड़ दिया, you can easily see that soil will settle down at the bottom of this glass. And lighter particles which are present in soil, they are floating over the surface. Or we can say that the mixture component is not uniform. Heavier particles settle down or lighter particles starts floating. So composition of this mixture is not uniform. So this is an example of heterogeneous mixture. Now, here I told you that I have one glass of plain water. If I mix some amount of salt in it, what would happen? Is it possible to you that only by viewing this solution, this is called as salt solution, okay? Now, salt completely dissolved in it, and you can see that only just by viewing, you are not able to identify whether this is plain water or it is salty water. What does it mean? इससे हमें क्या पता चलता है? इससे हमें ये पता चलता है कि जो salt crystals हैं, salt के particles हैं, वो water molecules में completely dissolve हो गए. And the composition of this solution is uniform throughout the mixture. इस पूरे mixture का composition पूरे सब तरफ से equal है. Means it is an example of uniform solution, or we can say it is an example of homogeneous mixture. In which two or more components are completely dissolved in each other and there is no demarcation of components. आप इसको देख करके नहीं बता सकते हैं कि salt particles कहाँ हैं, water particles कहाँ पर हैं. It seems to be a uniform. It means there is no such demarcation of components of mixture. Okay. Now, homogeneous mixtures also called as solutions. Children, now we will describe the definition of homogeneous mixture. Solutions are homogeneous mixture means they have uniform composition of two or more non-reacting components. The word here non-reacting, it means components should not react with each other. As we have seen in this example that when we dissolve salt in water, salt does not react with water. Salt water ke molecule se chemical reaction nahi karta. Preparation of a mixture is completely physical change. Okay. So the components should be non-reacting. If components with react with each other means agar salt particles water particles se chemical reaction kar lenge to kis cheez ka formation hoga, that is compound will be formed. Okay, so these components must be non-reacting and dissolve completely in each other. As we have already seen that salt particles are completely dissolved in water. So this is the definition of solutions. These are homogeneous mixture of two or more non-reacting components dissolved completely in each other. Whereas examples of colloids and suspension, milk, blood, soil, muddy water, all these are examples of heterogeneous mixtures. They have non-uniform composition. Now children, binary solutions means there are various types of solutions on the basis of number of components. As in this one, we have only two components, salt plus water. If I add one more component in it, means if I add sugar in it, then it has three components. So, solutions or mixtures which have only two components are called as binary solutions or binary mixtures. Our ninth class study is related with matter is totally concentrated on binary solutions only. It means we will discuss all types of mixtures which have only two components. So binary solutions are those mixtures in which only two components are present. Okay, now if two components are present, one component is called as solute and other component is called as solvent. Okay children, so how can you identify that which one is solute and which one is solvent? As I have given one example of salty water, okay, it contains salt as well as water. Two components are there, so it is an example of binary solution. But how can you identify that which one is solute and which one is solvent? So here there is a description to identify solute and solvent. Solutes are substance which is dissolved in a given medium. Matlab, solute wo substance hota hai jo kisi bhi medium mein isko hum dissolve karte hain. Here salty water, which substance I have dissolved? Kaun si substance ko maine dissolve kiya? That is salt. So salt here is an example of solute. Okay. Second, let us define definition of solvent. Substance in which solute is to be dissolved. मतलब वो substance जिसमें solute dissolve किया जाता है. यहाँ हमने किसमें dissolve किया? Water में. So water works as a solvent. Clear children? But this is not necessary that always all the time we can come to know that this substance is dissolved in this medium. It is not possible. So we must have one more criteria to identify that in a given mixture which one is solute and which one is solvent. So the second criteria is solute is always less in amount and solvent is always more in amount. Okay, so if amount of components are given to you, you can easily identify that which one is solute and which one is solvent. Children, solutions kaise prepare kiye jaate hain? Jab hum solute ko solvent mein mix karte hain, to solutions prepare hote hain. Now solute may be in any state of matter. Solute solid bhi ho sakta hai. We can take a liquid solute or we can take a gaseous solute. As well as solvent can be present in any state of matter. It may be solid, liquid or gaseous form. So on the basis of physical state of solute and solvent, solutions are of many types. So let us discuss about these types of solutions. First is when we mix solid in solid. It means solute is in solid state as well as solvent is also in solid state. Example of such kind of solutions are alloys. What are alloys? Alloys are the mixtures, homogeneous mixtures, which are formed by the mixing of one metal with non-metal or one metal with another metal. It means अगर हम दो या दो से ज़्यादा metals को mix करें और homogeneous mixture prepare करें उसे हम alloy कहेंगे, या फिर एक metal और another non-metal को mix करके भी हम solutions या alloys बना सकते हैं. For example, stainless steel. स्टेनलेस स्टील का प्रिपरेशन जब आयरन को कार्बन के साथ मिक्स करते हैं तो हमें स्टील के प्रिपरेशन होती है. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एलॉय आर ब्रास कॉपर प्लस जिंक, ब्रॉन्ज कॉपर प्लस टिन. सो देयर आर मेनी मोर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ एलॉयज एंड एलॉयज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर्स इन विच सॉल्यूट एंड सॉल्वेंट बोथ आर फाउंड इन द लिक्विड सॉलिड स्टेट. ओके, second category of solutions is when we mix liquid in solid. It means what is the state of solute? Liquid. And state of solvent is solid. Examples of these kinds of solutions are hydrated salt. Hydrated salts, yes children, this is a new term for you. Hydrated salt वो salt होते हैं जिनमें water molecules किसी भी कंपाउंड के साथ फिजिकली अटैच होते हैं. इट मीन्स देयर इज नो केमिकल बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड सॉल्ट. एग्जांपल्स ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ सॉल्ट्स आर कॉपर सल्फेट, पेंटाहाइड्रेट. इसमें कॉपर सल्फेट के एक मॉलिक्यूल के साथ में पांच मॉलिक्यूल वाटर के अटैच होते हैं. एंड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमनेस्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस वन इज प्लास्टर ऑफ पेरिस. चिल्ड्रन, आप सभी लोगों ने प्लास्टर ऑफ पेरिस तो जरूर देखा होगा. दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ हाइड्रेटेड सॉल्ट. वॉशिंग पाउडर, यू मस्ट यूज वॉशिंग पाउडर और योर मदर मस्ट यूज वॉशिंग पाउडर एट योर होम. एग्जाम्पल फॉर्मूला ऑफ दिस इज Na2CO3 10H2, मीन्स सोडियम कार्बोनेट डेकाहाइड्रेट. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डेका हियर? डेका मीन्स 10 वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स आर अटैच्ड विद 1 मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ सोडियम कार्बोनेट. एंड वेन दिस water molecules are attached with any of the compound molecule, they give a particular color to that substance. As you can see that washing powder is available in the market in various colors. So how can we prove that there is only physical attachment with water molecules and compound? For this one we can do one activity, or you can do one activity after this video session. Okay, what you will do, आपको क्या करना है children, कि एक टेबल स्पून के अंदर थोड़ा सा वॉशिंग पाउडर लेना है और जब आप उसको हीट करेंगे तो वॉशिंग पाउडर का कलर जो है वो चेंज हो जाएगा. व्हाई कलर विल बी चेंज? द रीजन इज ओनली दैट दीज वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स दे विल इवेपोरेट. जब हम किसी भी सब्सटेंस को गर्म करते हैं तो उसमें जितना भी कंटेंट वाटर का होता है वो इवेपोरेट हो जाता है, और ये वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स जब इवेपोरेट हो जाएंगे तो वॉशिंग पाउडर का कलर जो है वो कलर किसी भी कलर से वो वाइट कलर में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा. It shows that this particular compound is an example of hydrated salt. Hydrated word is particularly related with water molecules. Now the next category of solution is when gases are dissolved in solids. Means what is the state of solute? Gaseous state, and solvent is present in solid state. Examples are gases absorbed by metals. Generally gases are not absorbed by matter, but it happens in a particular condition. For example, in some of the condition hydrogen is absorbed by platinum. Platinum is most non-reactive element or non-reactive metal, or we can say it is noble metal, but still in some of the particular conditions hydrogen gas is absorbed by platinum. Okay, so this is the rarest example in which gases are dissolved in solids, but still in chemistry we can find some of the examples. Next category of solution is when solids are dissolved in liquid. It means solute is present in solid state whereas solvent is present in liquid state. This is the most commonest example of solutions. Salt in water, sugar in water are some of the examples of these kinds of solutions. Next is when liquids are dissolved in liquids. It means solute and solvent both are present in liquid state. Alcohol plus water, acetone plus water, the basic criteria of these kinds of solutions are both liquids should be miscible. Means both liquids should be dissolved in each other completely. Because what was the first criteria or first essential condition of solutions? That substances or components must be dissolved in each other uniformly. So when two miscible liquids are dissolved in each other, we get this kind category of solutions. Next is when gases are dissolved in liquid. Again, it is very common in our daily life, oxygen dissolved in water. This is the major source of oxygen for aquatic life. Okay, one more example, aerated drinks. Our students must be fond of cold drinks. What that cold drinks? Cold drinks are aerated drinks in which carbon dioxide is dissolved in carbonic acids or water. Okay. Next is when solids are dissolved in gaseous state. In this category, solid is an example of solute and solvent is present in gaseous state. Solid, solute and gas, solvent. All sublime substances. What are sublime substances? So, a quick recall for this one. Substances which convert into vapor state without going through liquid state are called as sublime substances. And the process of this conversion is called as sublimation. Examples are iodine camphor. It means if I keep iodine in open air, what will happen? It will convert into vapor. So these iodine vapors that are present in air at that time is an example of solids present in gaseous state. Okay. Next is liquid in gases. Means air in gases, that is aerated drinks. But what happens if we dissolve liquid in gases? Examples, water droplets present in air. That is one of the reason of humidity. And humidity is maximum in coastal areas, as we know this one. Last form of solution, that is when gases dissolve in gases. Air is the most commonest example of this one, in which we can take nitrogen as a solvent and all other gases, hydrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, these are considered as a solid. So children, with the help of this table, we have learned that how many types of solutions are there on the basis of physical state of solute as well as physical state of solvent. So all the students, if you want to take a screenshot, just take a screenshot. And children, this is all about solutions. In our next lecture, we will discuss about properties of colloids as well as suspension, means heterogeneous mixtures. Thank you. Have a nice day.